Happy Monday, everyone! We are back at day 3 for Touch of Disney, and today's gonna be a whole Pixar day type of thing. Let's go and get some Lobster Nachos over at the Lamplight Lounge. Let's go! We made it in. Okay, so quick story. We were just a tad bit late. There is a semi-long queue to get in, but we made it in and we're about to order. So as we place our order, I'm going to show you the menu, and we also ordered 2 drinks.
Yep.
All right, guys. So first off, they do give you the QR code and this cool square that says Lamplight Lounge. This is all paper here. So they have the English and the Spanish menu, which is pretty cool because I don't think I've seen other restaurants have menus for 2 different languages.
Yep.
But the bonus, and as always, you do get some coasters. Are these cool? They do come in a set of 6, I think. So you can ask nicely, and sometimes the cast member can hand you a full set. Have to ask nicely, and sometimes they do, sometimes they don't.
All right, brother, tell us about your lanyard.
My lanyard?
Yes.
Well, it's the Pixar Fest lanyard. I have Woody and Buzz, but in Cars form. That's what you get to see in front of the Cars Land during the Pixar Fest. And then I have the logo say Pixar Fest. And then the 6 pins are the annual pass holder pins. They came out during Pixar Fest. It was really cool.
Okay, guys. Ooh, my hair's crazy. Okay, so we have here the fun wheel, and this one has gin, light rum, execution, passion fruit liqueur, fruit curacao, sweet and sour, soda water, and it's garnished with the lemon lime foam, but it didn't come with a lemon lime foam. And yours, what did you get?
I got the zombie!
Alright, so the zombie one here has coconut rum, and light rum, and spice rum, and 151 proof rum, curacao, pineapple juice, orange juice, and it's garnished with 3 strawberries, but I think your zombie ate 1 because you only got 2.
Yep.
So excited. So these are part of the secret menu items, or secret menu drinks. They do have a secret menu thing going on here, so don't be afraid to ask. Cast members know exactly what you're talking about. Just give them the name and then they can make it for you. Are you ready to try it?
Yes, I am.
Oh, it's so good. I like this one. The reason I like it is because it's the perfect amount of sweet. Sweet and sour, but it's perfect. I like it. If you guys ever need something sweet and sour, definitely try the fun wheel. And when the fun wheel is on, I mean, it's a super cute picture, right?
All right. All over there.
Oh, the coconut. If you guys don't like coconuts, I wouldn't recommend this one just because the coconut is strong enough. It's strong enough that if you like coconut, it's going to be delicious.
So good. You're going to like this one.
Yeah?
This used to be the Cove Bar, and the sit-down restaurant was Ariel's Grotto.
Uh-huh.
But it got remodeled when Paradise Pier turned into Pixar Pier. So this whole pier here is themed after Pixar. So. But they did keep the Lobster Nachos.
Yep.
That I think are coming soon. Okay, so my brother's gonna have to eat this one. I will eat his serrano peppers. But these are the famous Lobster Nachos. You got lobster there, you got cheese sauce, you got like a spicy crema type of thing. That's why the cream, the crema, and the beans, it's just a no-no for me. But we got pico de gallo. My mouth is watering and I'm so mad. I forgot. It's been a year. Go get it together. But we got, like I said, lobster, pico. It does come with black beans. You can always, if there's something you don't like, you can always ask for them not to add it, like the serranos and stuff. But I personally love serranos, so I don't have a problem with that. We also got some potato skins. Okay, I will admit, I'm not a huge fan of the whole thinking of how they spread that out. But the potato skins are pretty good. And we also got the Impossible Burger. So this is supposed to be the pastrami burger, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm curious because I don't think it's pastrami. I see pineapple though, but I'm excited to try it. And here's some potatoes. I'm so hungry. Let's get started. I'm going to switch you with the burger.
Okay.
I'm so mad. So here we go. We got some, wait, is the Impossible Pastrami just pineapple?
No, there's not.
So we got some mustard, pineapple, mostly pastrami. Huh. I wonder if they brought us the wrong one.
No, because it was supposed to be like a pastrami spiced burger. So it's like the burger is spiced like the pastrami.
This looks really good. I'm gonna try the bread because it's a brioche bread. So this is pineapple. I want to say maybe this is the pastrami. I don't know. We got to investigate that. But this does not taste like Impossible. It's Impossible, man. I guess it doesn't taste beefy, but it's just weird. But it's not exactly what I thought it was. So I guess the pastrami thing is supposed to be the pineapple, which I would never think of adding mustard and pineapple.
Uh-huh.
So it gives it a different taste. It's a 4 out of 5 because I see what they're going for, and I'm pretty sure these are Disney pickles. But I'm not exactly sure where I stand on it. Ooh, the Lobster Nachos. Yes, thank you so much. Thank you. My lobster just fell over. This, today's a mess. Don't laugh at me.
Of course, I'm laughing at you. I'm laughing with
it's
you.
Hot.
Oh.
You want my serrano?
You got my serranos. You have many serranos are going through.
I'm just so excited. Oh my god. That's so good. This is amazing. This is a meal by itself. Wow. I missed you. I want you to know that I missed you. Cheers, guys. Cheers. Happy Monday, guys. Cheers. How exactly I feel about this burger, though. I think I have to have another bite, but the potatoes are good. Oh, the fries. They're good. You guys, you might end up getting full. We like to eat a lot. But you guys might end up getting full with this and might not enjoy the rest of the event. If you don't happen to get reservations, it's okay, don't feel bad. Once Disney reopens, this place will reopen as well to everyone, not just like ticket-wise. When you do actually guys get come here, please try the lobster nachos. You might like the barbacoa more like Jane did, but the barbacoa ones are good. But there's nothing like the lobster ones. So good. One last bite. One more bite. Oh my goodness.
Please, you're not in touch with potato skins. I see you.
Oh! Sorry. Potato skins. I forgot about them. You know, these potato patties are really good. There's something about the whole way that this is like made. With the design of it that I don't like it, but I'll dip it into this.
I like it.
I don't find that feeling though.
No, because it's supposed to represent like balance, you know, like a painting, like a brush
I don't
stroke.
Like it looks kind of gross and ugly. But it does have paper, so if you don't like paper, they're actually better than last time, the first time we tried them.
Yeah.
Come out right.
Oh, this looks
good. Everything tastes good so far?
Very, very good. Thank you. Potato skins are good. They're nice and crispy. The sauce is kind of like a spicy sriracha type of thing. And then this one is like a mayonnaise, capery. Honestly, I think I like this one better. You can't go wrong with this. Cheers, guys. Happy Monday.
We did get the Neverland tea and we got the sea witch. So excited. So they topped it with some orange and a raspberry and the Neverland tea with pineapple. Let's give it a go. I think you're gonna like this one. This one's my brother's. Hold on. Oh, I like this one. Okay, so the Neverland tea, it has vodka, gin, peach schnapps, rucola cacao, pineapple juice, and Sprite. You would definitely taste the peach in this one.
Peachy?
It's peachy. I'm liking the drink for that. So pretty. All right, guys, after you swirl the Neverland tea, it does turn green, just FYI. And the sea witch turned kind of like a blue raspberry type of color.
Yeah.
Very delicious, though. Okay, nachos were delicious, but I think we're gonna call it a day for that, for Lamplight just today. We have four drinks. We have the sea witch, we have the Neverland tea, we had the fun wheel, and then we had the zombie. Delicious, by the way. The only thing is the sea witch kind of tastes like cough syrup, so if you guys don't like that, don't order it. I happen to like cough syrup because I'm weird. The burger again, it was kind of weird. Like, it had a lot of flavors all at once, but it didn't make sense. We're gonna go head over to the adorable snowman and we're gonna go get something cold. Then after that, we're gonna go to the Culture Palace and we're gonna get more food. Then we're gonna head over to Bing Bong's and we're gonna try to see if we can get the two cake pops. Guys, we'll see you if we find them.
So before I forget, you can get your, what are they, like limited edition tip coins?
I heard it's a while supplies last.
It's a while supplies last, but these are the commemorative Lamplight coins. Here they are. Here's the other side. It's a one-sided coin Lamplight Lounge. I believe there are $8.99 for a set of two, and you can get up to five sets. So we actually got these on Friday, but we just wanted to show it to you guys since we were coming back today again. And here are some of the coaster designs for you guys to see. All right, so we're done here. We're gonna head up and have some dessert. So come along with us, guys, as we go have some dessert, and then we're gonna show you the pier. All right.
So right here, I think they call it the Incredible Square, because like over right here, it's all themed to Incredibles, even with the fountain over here. So you have the Incredible Square, you got the Toy Story area.
Okay, guys, so there's a little change of plans. So we did mobile order the adorable frosted treats, but our time window is like at 4 something. So we're gonna head over to Bing Bong, see if we can get the cake pops, and after that, we're gonna go see if we can play some games. I don't know if games are still free. On opening day, they were free because apparently there was like a little something wrong and people were getting prices. I don't know, we're gonna check it out. If games are free, maybe we could try to get a Bambino over La Luna. We'll see what's open, but I'm really excited for this cake pops. They do have some seats here, guys, if you wanna sit down and eat your pulse palace or your ice cream. This Midway Mania. Where Mr. Potato Head can be found. Here's Pulse Palace, guys. So they do have a QR code, so you can see their menu. So it appears in the shorts.
Yes. It's called Small Fry. Mm-hmm. And so basically Bonnie goes takes her toys to the Culture Palace. And she ended up losing Buzz, the small miniature Buzz. You can see like miniature Zerg, there's a miniature Buzz. The miniature Buzz wanted to be a real toy, so he ended up escaping and then he switched out with the real Buzz. So the miniature Buzz goes with Bonnie back to home. And as Buzz is stuck in the Poultry Palace, he's trying to find a way to escape the Poultry Palace.
Oh, that's cool. I wonder if we can see this over Disney Plus.
Yes, you can. You can see this on Disney Plus.
Alright, so check it out, guys. It's called
Small Fry.
Small Fry. Check it out on Disney Plus so you guys can know more about this. But the theming is amazing. Also, when you buy the chicken box, you get one of these cool Poultry Palace chicken boxes. Let me just show you a quick view. I know this. We said this was a Pixar edition, but look at the view from here. that right there is Little Mermaid. And then that is the silver, what's it called?
The Golden Surfer.
The Golden Surfer, even though it's silver. And then we have the Pixar Palaround over there. Your bus, which is the upcoming churro cart here, is closed. They have like a hot cinnamon churro, which kind of tastes like a, what's that candy? They're like a hot tamale. I know what I'm talking about. I'm kind of sad this one's not here. So these angry dogs, they have the slightly annoyed dog over at a word wiener, but in a corn dog style.
Yes.
Over here, it's just a hot dog. I've actually never had one, only because it's just like a spicy link.
Yeah.
But we'll make sure you get one next time we're here. Oh man, it's a busy day at the games here. The popcorn cart is open though. $5 for popcorn or $9 for the souvenir. You can also find the Winnevere picture truck right over here for $18.75. Oh, the line is long here. Busy day of the year. Also, if you guys want your legacy pass holder pin, once you exit, the picture up here is when you'll see the AP corner. But here's Bing Bonks. I am ready for that, that King Pop. Hopefully we can find it. Because last time we came, the King Pops were sold out. There's a cute photo pass here to Infinity and Beyond. We actually got a chance to take a picture here. They have a few today. What I've noticed is sometimes during the day, certain parts are busier than others. Like Pixar Pier seems to be a little busier today, right in the morning. So just wait a couple minutes, wait a couple hours, come back and check it out. All right, guys, before I forget, over the Solution Swings is where you're going to find some of the characters like Mickey and Donald. No, not Donald. Mickey and Pluto and Daisy. We actually ran into Conductor Mickey, but we couldn't take a quick picture of him. He was leaving, but let's see if we can find him around. Alright. Okay, so we left Pixar Pier.
Yeah.
But did you guys know that Cars Land is also part of Pixar? We're actually heading into Cars Land to get a little sweet something because Pixar Pier was a little too crowded for us.
Yep.
So we're gonna go to the Coasty Cone Motel number 1 to get some ice cream because it's a hot day.
Yep.
Alright guys, I don't know why, but I feel like today, Monday, it feels a little more crowded than opening day. They sold the same amount of tickets, so we know they didn't oversell tickets, but it just feels a little more crowded. Maybe because more families came today. That's what I'm seeing. I'm seeing more families today than the other day. Like more strollers, more kids. I don't know.
Look at that photo. They actually brought the Luigi's
car. That's what I was gonna say. I'm gonna go take a picture over the Casa de los Tires. So let's get in line for that because we have about 10 minutes for our food to be ready. And by food, I mean a lot of sugar. So let's go take a picture.
All right.
Cast member use the blue one more than the other one. I think the light is just perfect for that one right now. But it's pretty cool. He takes about, I want to say, 4 different pictures, different poses. So we're done. And we did it. We took pictures.
Yep.
So I guess my phone overheated because I couldn't. It was bright enough, but the QR code didn't want to link up to his device. So I did end up getting a little card that says view, download, and share. So it's a PhotoPass card. Now we're trying to phone the pickup line for code number 2 and 1. I think the way that they changed it was now cast members are here trying to direct you just because the line got a lot bigger. If you guys haven't seen the day, opening day one, go and check it out so you guys can see how long the lines were. Our food's ready. Okay, so they do have cast members. Like I said, they're blocking the way. There was a long queue here on Thursday on opening day, but we're gonna head over to our cone. It's cone 1 for churro, cone 2 for ice cream, cone 3 for the chili con queso, and cone number 4 for the popcorn. I'm not sure, actually cone number 4 was drinks or something. Cone number 5 is popcorn. But I don't think those two are open. But we're gonna head over to the ice cream and the churro cone. We'll see you in a bit. Guys, we are in for a treat because you can also add, I believe for 99 cents, you can add the road gravel, which is, I believe it's like a mixture of everything, but you guys will get to see. They have toppings. I believe it's 99 cents per topping. I chose the road gravel just because it sounded fun, and back at Flo's road gravel was just Oreos. So we'll see what we get. I love the Cozy Cone Motel, guys. Their small bites and small stuff that you can eat and keep enjoying the park and not getting too overfull with like a sit-down restaurant, so. We did it! This is what it looks like. A little bit of everything. Let's go take some pictures. But it has chocolate chips, sprinkles, peanuts, road gravel, a little bit of everything. Oh, it's called the Junkyard Cone. Or the Junkyard topping. Alright guys, so not all the tables get cleaned up really quick, but that's why we always bring our wipes with us. So we're gonna sanitize this table and then we're gonna have our ice cream. Alright guys, we gotta work this fast. Ice cream is melting because it's getting hot, but a cast member did come over and clean that table. Like I said, we're working on that pretty fast, so.
We just had to work faster than them because our ice cream was melting. Okay. Junkyard ice cream cone, again, has everything on it. Like road gravel is the Oreo. They have sprinkles and chocolate chip. It's nice and refreshing. I mean, after the saltiness from the lobster nachos and the potato skins and that, I don't know what type of burger that was. It's a good treat. But don't forget, we're going back to the pier.
Time for a little stop over here with Lightning McQueen. He brought a little treat too. Alright guys, so we just met Lightning McQueen and we did a ka-chow with the milk and the cookies churro. So here it is. We haven't tried it because we want to take a couple pictures. But we're going to step to the side. We're going to pull over.
Yep.
In Cars Woods.
Yep.
And we're going to try the milk and cookies churro. I believe it's what? Cinnamon and cookies and cream?
I think so.
Okay, so here they are, and here is the dipping sauce. I want to say it's frosting and some Oreos, maybe? Some gravel?
Yep.
First bite. That's not bad, but your tongue is better.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. The dip is a little too sweet for me.
Yeah?
This treat that we're about to go get is 100% Pixar Edition.
Yes?
Just wait till you see it.
100%. That's the Victory Campus.
Mm-hmm.
I think that should be the Sanctum Sanctuary. Mm-hmm. But I know it should be like right here, about right there. Because in the concept art, it showed it was right here. That is the tent right here. And as you can see it. So you need a cast member to tell you where to go. Because like it's so dumb. It's always disorganized with this.
Okay, so I really appreciate all the work the cast members do. But I feel like they always let them know how the whole system's gonna be working the same day. It's, because one cast member does one thing, another cast member does another thing, and they always make you go back and forth. So we were in the pickup line and then we ended up in the order line, which by the way, you can order here. You don't have to do just mobile order.
Yeah.
The good way was kind of like research.
Yeah.
But the bad way, because we actually wanted to get our treat now.
Yeah.
But it was free trip, so we're gonna take it as a good thing.
All right, sister, what do you order that's so Pixar?
Well, my brother, I ordered a Mickey waffles with berries, as strawberries, blueberries, and some whipped cream. I did get two, but they skimped out on your berries. I don't know why. I mean, that's yours. So I did order the Mickey waffle, and they put some maple syrup on it. I also ordered a drink, a farm stand punch drink.
Think so?
This one was like last year's festival or something like that.
Yeah.
So I got that. It looks delicious. It has a little lemon slice in there. And we did get this last time, but we got them again. This is the new glow cubes. It has a hidden Mickey. So they're the grape glow cubes charms. Right. Have the green ones and the red ones. They are $5. And I'm ready to try this.
All right. Well, that's it. Like, how is this Pixar? It's supposed to be Pixar Edition.
You don't see Pixar on it?
No.
What's more Pixar than this?
So this is the straw from the, during the Pixar Fest, they had this straw. It was Luxo Jr. But also, you could buy this straw at the Lamplight Lounge.
Where we had lunch.
Yep.
I really wanted the waffles, guys. And because I knew that today's video was going to be Pixar, I knew my brother was going to ask me what was Pixar about this. So I decided to bring that. And I mean, if we add... Okay, so like I said, it does have whipped cream. It has the berries. Look at that Mickey waffle. I've been craving this waffle. Go with the ear. Over to the jeweler's booth. The berries, the waffle, the syrup.
That's so good. It feels like breakfast at the park.
All right, guys, we're back at Pixar Pier. I am full. But we already ordered two treats from the adorable salmon. Let's have the, it's lemon pineapple swirl.
Yep.
Because it was delicious and I want it again.
Yep.
And you're having dill whip.
Yep.
Also, look, they're filming. This is Park Vlog, it's filming. So adorable snowman frosted treats. Our ice cream is ready. Let's go get in line. Mobile order number 4. Pick up with the number 4.
So this is the cone from the adorable snowman. We have the it's lemon side and then the pineapple, which is the Dole Whip. This is the best of both worlds because the it's lemon cone, it's delicious. The parfait one. Whenever the parks fully reopen, try the parfait one. So I'm really excited for that one. We did have it last time, but here is a classic Dole Whip, guys. Look at the cup. So this is the classic Dole Whip they did bring in from Disneyland. I'm gonna give this one a try first. Mmm. Combination of its lemon and the Dole Whip, it's perfect. It's delicious.
Goes with the song.
Last treat of the day will be Poultry Palace.
Yep.
Well, actually, we're gonna pick up the if found the cake pop.
Yep.
And then the last few will be Poultry Palace.
Yep.
I don't know if you guys can see, but that place right there, right here, that's where the secret lounge is, the office. The Pixar office over the Lamplight. Alright, finally the line's not that long.
Yep.
We're gonna try to see if we can play a game.
Yep.
Have you seen anybody leaving with prices?
So far not yet.
We'll see.
Yep. We'll
and
see.
You said the machine is down to buy a play card?
Yes.
So I'm guessing they're free right now?
Probably or something.
Start of the round. Oh, you gotta do the name for the center of your target. The second one we need up to the stop. First one on the top is the winner. And the blue light here will tell you who the winner is.
All right, here's your report.
All right.
They, after the party place, they sanitized the games and the seats and the table and everything.
Yep.
There is plexiglass.
Yes.
I think only one group, one party can play it at a time. Okay, no prizes.
Yep.
And it's free to play.
Okay.
Our turn.
All right.
Let me win. Please. Okay.
Thank you.
$1,000 you gotta do is aim for the center of your target to send the lonely Eve up from the stall.
Alright. First one of the top is the winner, and the blue light up here will tell you who the winner is. Perfect. Ready? On your get set and blast off. Let me win. That was fun.
We're almost done. We have the memory refresher from Bing Bong's.
You call it Earth Day?
Yep. Because you got the inner core, the outer core, the crust, and then the sea. See what I did there?
Oh, green face. All right, we got one more trick for you guys. That is the Poultry Palace.
Yep.
You ready?
Yes. All right,
let's try everything.
And before I forget, guys, we did mention that Bing Bong was selling the Lamplight coins. They do sell them. We just wanted to confirm to you guys. So if you can't get a Lamplight reservation and you really want those collectible Lamplight coins, stop over by Bing Bong's. They are $8.99 for a set of two. Come on over to Bing Bong's and you can get your Lamplight coins. So don't forget to check it out.
We did get the box, and the boxes are $9.99. So we actually use our gift cards for this, right?
Huh?
So this is one of the only places that they don't do mobile order, but the lines aren't that long. Here's what it looks inside. It comes with coleslaw. One thing that I didn't know from the first time we tried it was that they actually have hot sauce and barbecue sauce.
Oh.
Because they asked us if we wanted some, so I got one of each.
Oh, that's new, because I never seen that he offered us.
Right, I remember that. And we got a sport.
Yep.
Also, we are where the Toy Story Mania fast passes are distributed.
Yep.
But they're closed right now.
Mm-hmm.
So we do get some coleslaw. The only thing about this box that I didn't like the first time we tried it was the coleslaw. So hopefully it's better than the first time.
Yep.
Very pickly. I like pickles. Okay, a little better.
Yeah?
I honestly don't remember why, but I didn't like the coleslaw the first time I tried it. This was pretty good. It's very pickly. This one's so tiny! I've been creating this chicken for a while. I grabbed the weirdest one.
Yes, you did.
The rub? I think the rub has like sugar or something, because there's something sweet on the rub. But it's like a smoky, it has a little spice, like a little kick to it. It's not spicy, it just has a little kick to it. But what I remember was not having a lot of like flavor, like a lot of salt. And they don't have a lot of salt. So if you don't like salty foods, just definitely one for you.
How's the hot sauce?
Like a taco sauce.
Mm.
I kind of like it without it though.
Also, guys, one more thing. Here's another Pixar thing before we guys leave. Here, Miguel comes out here and I greet you, everybody. And right here's the remark to take your photo in front of Miguel. All right, that's it.
All right, guys, as we're making our way out to the exit, I forgot to let you guys know that we didn't find the cake pops. So we'll try next time we come. Those are like super popular right now, so they keep selling out fast. Next time we'll take a picture and we'll eat one. All right, bye guys.